At very high, the universe was practically homogeneous, and the temperature of matter and radiation dropped as the universe expanded. Atoms formed at when the temperature was at a low enough value for the plasma to recombine. At this epoch of recombination, the cosmic microwave background filled the universe with a red, uniformly bright glow of blackbody radiation, but later the temperature dropped and the cosmic microwave background shifted to the infrared. To human eyes, the universe would then have appeared as a completely dark place. A long period of time had to pass until the first objects collapsed, forming the first stars that shone in the universe with the first light ever emitted that was not part of the cosmic microwave background. The period of time between the last scattering of the cosmic microwave background radiation by the homogeneous plasma and the formation of the first star has come to be known as the Dark Age of the Universe. Hence, the time between 400,000 years ago and the birth of the first stars is referred to as the Dark Ages. Nothing was present for it to emit. There was Big Bang light still present, but no things were communicating with us. So, using our best knowledge of gravity, quantum physics, nuclear fusion physics, and all of this, we compute and apply. We put our finest thinking gear on and estimate that it will take 1 or 2 billion years to only start the stars. Then a galaxy can form if there are enough stars in one location to do so. A galaxy will also contain sufficient light for you to see clearly at a considerable distance. Individual stars would be exceedingly difficult to see. So this is our understanding of the early universe. But now we want to learn more about the early universe and how galaxies are born. So we make James Webb Space Telescope. So what exactly is James Webb Space Telescope, you ask? NASA's James Webb Space Telescope, the agency's successor to the famous Hubble Telescope, launched on December 25, 2021, is on a mission to study the earliest stars and peer back farther into the universe's past than ever before.
So, I'm an astronomer, and this launch is a huge deal for me. I am personally really, really excited. But why is this such a big event for everyone? The Webb Telescope is nothing less than humanity's next effort to move closer to understanding some of the biggest questions about the origin of our universe. And it's not just the origins of distant stars and galaxies, but it's the story of us, you and me, how we got here.
It is currently at its observing spot, nearly 1 million miles, 1.6 million kilometers. It is the largest and most powerful space telescope ever launched. So, what makes it unique? Since it is reasonable to expect that newly formed galaxies to emit large amounts of high-energy light, particularly ultraviolet light, and because specific kinds of newly formed stars emit large amounts of this type of light. Today, how do we perceive those galaxies? The ultraviolet light is no longer ultraviolet light if it was so long ago and the universe has grown. The wavelengths have been stretched 13.8 billion years later as the cosmos has expanded. Ultraviolet light from the early universe has now been stretched to create infrared light. Thus, we fine-tune the James Webb Space Telescope to detect infrared emission, which began as ultraviolet in the early universe. Infrared is also useful for peeking inside gas clouds in front of our nose to view the birth of stars that would otherwise be covered by the gas clouds from which they are produced. So the James Webb Space Telescope is good for stuff nearby, just as it's good for stuff long ago. So, let's turn on the telescope and watch galaxies form, and oh my gosh! We're discovering galaxies during the Dark Ages. And I'm told the lead researcher was so taken aback by this that he spit out his coffee when he discovered what kind of data he was dealing with. Nobody expected them. They were not supposed to be there. And now, nobody can explain how they had formed. Galaxies nearly as massive as the Milky Way and full of mature red stars seem to be dispersed in deep field images obtained by the James Webb Space Telescope during its early observation campaign, and they are giving astronomers a headache. These galaxies, described in a new study based on Webb's first data release, are so far away that they appear only as tiny reddish dots to the powerful telescope. By analyzing the light emitted by these galaxies, astronomers established that they were viewing them in our universe's infancy only 500 to 700 million years after the Big Bang. The galaxies found in the Webb images appeared shockingly big, and the stars in them are too old. The new findings are in conflict with existing ideas of how the universe looked and evolved in its early years, and don't match earlier observations made by Webb's less powerful predecessor, the Hubble Space Telescope. Young stars in general shine bright blue. With age, stars develop a redder glow as they burn through their fuel and cool down. In ancient galaxies that Webb was built to spot, astronomers had not expected to see old red stars. They also had not expected to find galaxies more massive than perhaps a billion suns. But those reddish dots revealed in Webb's deep fields appear 50 times more massive than that. Everything we know about matter and energy suggests that there will be a dark ages. Yet, we are witnessing galaxies during the dark ages.
Now, it takes many billions of years to create a galaxy, like the Milky Way galaxy, with 100 billion stars, many billions of years old. But the James Webb Telescope has identified six galaxies that exist half a billion years after the Big Bang that are up to 10 times bigger than the Milky Way galaxy. That shouldn't happen.
We have to go back and alter that in ways we don't yet know or understand. Or perhaps some new type of item, unlike any other object we've ever seen, formed easily during the Dark Ages. I won't even name them galaxies because they could be something else. Isn't a rainbow a spectrum of the sun? White light enters, passes through a raindrop, then emerges with its component colors. If you look closely, you can see the chemistry of what's going on in the sun, the chemical elements that are present. When you have the spectrum, you may also figure out things like how fast the sun rotates and other information. So if we can obtain the spectrum of these items, we'll be able to determine what they're made of. We will also be able to better place them in terms of distance. Perhaps something is tainting our assessment of its distance. And maybe they're actually on the verge of the Dark Ages, but they're acting as if they're a little further away, deep within the Dark Ages. Who can say? Alternatively, as some people like to think when they come across something they don't comprehend, they're aliens. In general, we reserve that for the last possible guess on something we don't comprehend. By the way, just to be fair, we created this telescope to assist us comprehend the formation of galaxies. Yes, it will help you grasp things you already had some notion of when you build a new telescope with access to moments, places, and regimes in the universe, open a new window on cosmic phenomena. But do you know what it always does? Creates discoveries you could never have predicted. And this is the glory of science.